So in the special series, first one, sum of first n natural numbers, comma sum of squares and sum of cubes of first n natural numbers. Now let us consider the first one, sum of first n natural numbers. That is 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n. This already we have proved as n into n plus 1 by 2. Now for this first method is we have used the arithmetic progression. Because the terms are in arithmetic progression, we can apply the sum of n terms of AP. So Sn equal to n by 2 into first term plus last term, that is 1 plus n, which is same as n into n plus 1 by 2, which you know before. Now the second method, consider k square minus k minus 1 whole square. Now when I consider this, it is in the form of a square minus b square. I can write as a minus b into a plus b. A minus b is 1 and a plus b is 2k minus 1. So this is called an identity, because this is true for all values of k. K belongs to n. Now substitute k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on n. When I substitute k equal to 1, 1 square minus 0 square equal to 2 into 1 minus 1, k equal to 2. 2 square minus 1 square equal to 2 into 2 minus 1 and so on. K equal to n. N square minus n minus 1 whole square equal to 2 into n minus 1. Add all the n equations. Then 1 square gets cancelled, 2 square gets cancelled. The left out terms are n square and 0. So left side is n square. In the right side, 2 will take common. 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n. Minus 1 is n times, so it is minus n. Take minus n to the left side. So n square plus n equal to 2 into 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n. Sum of n natural numbers, that is sigma n. So sigma n equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. Or another way I can write as sigma k, k equal to 1 to n is n into n plus 1 by 2. So the third method for sum of first n natural numbers is 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n, we are taking as a quadratic, a n square plus b n plus c. So why we are taking as a quadratic is because already we know that this we have derived as n into n plus 1 by 2, means sum of first n natural numbers is a quadratic. So that's why we are taking as a general form of quadratic, a n square plus b n plus c. Now we need to find the values of a, b, c. Because we need to calculate three constants, so substitute three numbers for n. Substitute n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3. Then we will get three equations. So a plus b plus c equal to 1, 4a plus 2b plus c equal to 3, 9a plus 3b plus c equal to 6. Now, use first equation, second equation. Then 4a minus a, 3a plus b equal to 2. Use second and third, 5a plus b equal to 3. Now here we have eliminated c. Now eliminate b, subtract the two equations, then 2a equal to 1, so a equal to 1 by 2. Substitute a equal to 1 by 2 in the fourth equation. Then I will get b equal to 2 minus 3 by 2, which is 1 by 2. Substitute a equal to 1 by 2, b equal to 1 by 2 in first equation, a plus b plus c equal to 1. Then you will find that c equal to 0. Substitute a, b, c in this equation. Then 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n equal to half n square plus half n plus 0. That is n into n plus 1 by. So this is the third method. Next, one more method also possible, that is mathematical induction. But right now we are not discussing mathematical induction. Later we'll discuss, because it's a separate topic. Just remember that this can be proved using mathematical induction also. So sum of squares of n natural number, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on n square, that you can prove it as n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 upon 6. Now here, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, they are not in arithmetic progression. So you cannot apply the formula of sum of n terms of AP. So the second method which you have done before, that can be applicable. That means let us consider k cube minus k minus 1 whole cube. That is difference of two consecutive cubes we have taken. Now when I simplify this, I'll get as 3k square minus 3k plus 1, which is true for all k belongs to n. Now substitute k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on n. And add all the n equations. In the left side, only n cube term will be left out. In the right side, 3 is common. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on n square. Minus 3 is common. 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on n. And 1 we are adding n times. So plus n. So n cube equal to 3 into sigma n square minus 3 into sum of first n natural numbers. Previously you have done n into n plus 1 by 2 plus n. Now take this term to the left side and simplify. Then you will get sigma n square as n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 upon 6. So here, instead of expanding first, you take common always. If you expand, it is very difficult to factorize. So whenever you are having anything common, you take first common and then only go for a simplification. Now this is a quadratic. It is factorizable easily. The second method is, so 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square and so on n square is a cubic polynomial. So write the general form of cubic. A n cube plus b n square plus c n plus d. Because we need to calculate four constant a, b, c, d. Substitute n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3 and n equal to 4. Form the four equations. And use first and second, eliminate d. Use second and third, eliminate d. Use third and fourth, eliminate d. Then you'll get three more equations. 7a plus 3b plus c equal to 4. 19a plus 5b plus c equal to 9. 37a plus 7b plus c equal to 16. Now eliminate c and get two more equations. So that will be 12a plus 2b equal to 5. 18a plus 2b equal to 7. Now eliminate b. Then you'll get the value of a. Substitute a equal to 1 by 3 in one of the previous equation. Then you'll find b equal to 1 by 2. And substitute a equal to 1 by 3, b equal to 1 by 2. In one of the equation of 5, 6, 7. Then you'll find c equal to 1 by 6. Substitute a base in the first equation. Then you'll find d equal to 0. Now substitute these values in a n cube plus b n square plus c n plus d. Then you'll find that it is n into n plus 1, 2 n plus 1 upon 6. One cube plus two cube plus three cube and so on n cube. That is sum of cubes of first n natural numbers. You can prove it as n square into n plus one whole square upon four. Now here also one cube, two cube, three cube, they are not in arithmetic progression. So you cannot apply any formula. Neither in AP nor in GP nor in HP. So you cannot apply any formula directly. Now we can consider k to the power of four minus k minus one whole to the power of four. That is consecutive difference of fourth power. Now, if you simplify this, you will find that 4k cube minus 6k square plus 4k minus 1. That means this you can simplify using a square minus b square formula. So, arrange in the form of a square minus b square. Factorize and further you expand and simplify. Now, substitute k equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on n in this equation because it is an identity. Add all the n equation. Then, left side you will get n power 4. In the right side, 4 into 1 cube plus 2 cube and so on. N cube you will get, which is same as sigma n cube minus 6 into 1 square plus 2 square and so on n square you will get, that is minus 6 sigma n square plus 4 into sigma n minus 1, you are adding n times, so it is minus n. Now n power 4 minus 6 sigma n square, take left side, so 6 into n plus 1 2 n plus 1 upon 6 minus 4 into n plus 1 upon 2 minus n becomes plus n equal to 4 into sigma n cube, reverse it. So 4 into sigma n cube. Take n common entirely. Once you take n common here, n cube will be there plus. Here n you have taken common. So n plus 1 into 2 n plus 1. 2 n square plus 3 n plus 1. Minus. Here n we have taken already common. 2 into n plus 1. So minus 2 n minus 2 and plus 1. Now 1 plus 1, 2 gets cancelled. So n cube plus 2 n square plus 3 n minus 2 n. N. Again n is common. So n square plus 2 n plus 1, which is same as n square into n plus 1 whole square. Now, therefore, sigma n cube, sum of cubes of first n natural numbers, n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4. So, the another method for sum of cubes of first n natural numbers is, we can take as sum of cubes of first n natural numbers as a biquadratic. That is general form of degree 4, a n power 4 plus b n cube plus c n square plus d n plus e. Now here we need to calculate phi constant. So to calculate phi constant, substitute n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And solve for a, comma b, comma c and d and e. Then you will find that a equal to 1 by 4, b equal to 1 by 2, c equal to 1 by 4, d equal to 0 and e equal to 0. And substitute this back. Then you will find that n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4.
Sir, done by solving full.